talking about causation in relation to God. That's from the very beginning.
You said causation
in relation to God. I didn't say creation because you are limiting to creation. I said, look, atemporally or temporally, when you say God causes something, what do you mean by that?
Does your God work within the parameters of everything within this creation?
Sorry?
Does your God operate?
No, you're asking me a different question. I'm asking you, when you use the word cause, you need to define it.
Sure.
Okay.
Go on. What do you mean by the word? No, no. You are defining. You are not defining. You are simply asking us, what do I understand by the word cause? What do I believe about it? Forget what I understand, what I believe.
He's not asking.
I am asking you, when you apply the word cause in the English language, it can mean various things, right? What do you mean when you say cause?
In relation to what? In what context?
God and the objects.
Sure. Okay. In that sense, the Son is eternally proceeding from the Father. The Son is eternally being caused by the Father.
Cause means being caused. Do you know what kind of fallacy this is?
Yeah.
Yeah, fine. Try again.
So he's eternally coming from the Father.
Eternally coming from the Father.
Did we say?
Is that what you mean by causation?
Both of us said it is to bring about a state of affairs, right? Okay, so if we include within a state of affairs also objects, entities, persons, beings, whatever, okay, right. Yeah. So God the Son is a person, right, who God the Father brings about, but eternally does so, and necessarily does so.
Let's understand that.
Okay.
So you have God here, and you have the object. There is no temporal relationship, it's atemporal, right?
Yeah, sure.
In a metaphysical sense.
In this example.
Now, atemporal. So this object, did it exist eternally without a beginning?
Yes. Yeah.
It exists without a beginning, right?
Yes.
Independent of the God.
No.
Is the existence of this object independent of God?
No. Not of God the Father, no.
It's not independent of God.
So the existence of this object,
and
the Son,
is reciprocal.
The object.
God the Father depends on the Son.
Hear what I'm saying.
Okay.
The very existence of this object called the Son is dependent on God causing it.
God the Father, yes.
Yeah? So that thing is not independent of God, which you affirm.
Yes.
And it is not eternal because it was caused.
Wait, why is it not eternal?
Okay. Yeah. All right. So it's okay. So it is eternally caused.
Yes.
Right.
Thank you.
So far we now have an object which is eternally caused.
Same.
Do you believe that God can create a universe atemporally like that?
Wait, say again.
Eternally, an object can be there eternally and God causing it to bring existence like he does the Son. So you have another thing called the universe.
Wait.
A universe which is also metaphysically atemporal and exists by the very dependency on being dependent on God.
Okay, my issue is that when we say creation, as we said earlier.
Not creation.
No. Okay,
this reality.
We said earlier on in the chat.
Is the Son a reality?
Wait, let me finish.
Wait,
as we understand it, we often understand that to be finite, okay? We've said that.
Right.
So when you're saying.
I'm not talking about this universe. Okay, I'm talking about a universe which is atemporally caused by God.
Yeah. But the atemporality of it doesn't mean that it's eternal. It's just
so you can have a universe atemporally caused by God.
I think the God I'm talking about is the God who is.
I'm asking you, the God that you believe in, is it possible that this creator, God, the Father, can cause a universe atemporally which exists all the time eternally?
I don't know if it could exist eternally.
You can do what?
Look, God is the one who's causing it, right? So we have someone who is the one who does the job, acting, the actor, files in our
way. No, God the Son as well also acts.
God the Father is the cause of the Son.
Yes.
Right? God the Father is the cause of the eternal universe. Is it possible in your belief system there can be a universe atemporally caused eternally by the creator God the Father?
Do I believe that he's done that?
Now, is it possible he could do that?
I don't know if it's actually
possible. Why is that relevant? Why would
it's important because I want to know.
Because my God chooses what he
wants. It's not about choice. I'm asking you, is it logically possible?
In principle, possible.
In principle, is it possible? Thank you.
I don't know if it is actually. I don't know. Because I don't know if by understanding what universe means properly, do we understand that it shouldn't be in principle eternal?
An object that God calls into existence.
You specified it as the universe, and I'm saying...
Not this universe.
I don't know, you said a
universe. Don't conflate with this universe.
No, I didn't say this universe.
Thank you.
A universe.
Yeah.
But I don't know if by using the term universe, most philosophers would understand that to have some finish.
I'm going to define what I mean by universe. Yeah. An universe is an object which has some reality. Say, for example, it's got stars in it. That's all. A universe has got lots of stars within it. So, in principle, is God the Father in your Trinitarian belief system logically, in principle, able to cause a universe with stars in it, which is atemporally caused and eternal?
I'm not sure, but I'll say perhaps for the sake of the argument, just because I need to be more philosophically precise on what it actually meant by universe.
Why don't you think about it, and we talk next week on this issue.
Okay,
let's leave it to that. Okay,
nice talking to you. Can I have a second?